So I wanted to bring this up. I saw this interesting video at 8 at the Table, and it's about this woman. She's from the Caribbean, and she says she's bisexual. She talks about being bisexual, and let's just watch. She talks about coming out to her family. Let's just watch it.
They were very strict because, you know, the Bible says a woman should not wear a man's garment, so I never wore pants. I always wore hats. I always, you know, that whole, the Pentecostal thing is women should dress modest. So I never, like, let on for my parents to know that that was who I was inside. And I know there's actually girls that went to my church that are gay. Like, they're gay, I'm bi, but, you know, they were living in that secret as well. I want to settle down with a man. That's why I'm bisexual. You know, I'm not, females that identify as gay, they are in relationships and want to settle down with a woman. I prefer to settle with a man. I prefer to have a family with a man. I prefer to have a husband. That's why I'm bisexual. I like women. I love the idea of women. I love, you know, the company of women. But I think with most bisexual females, we love all of that, but we still would want to be with a man. But I don't think we go into it and say, oh, we're going to be 70 this and 30 that.
You're watching the Kenim O Show, and I'm your host, Kenim O. This video is brought to you by mintedculture.com, where you can check out all of my content. I have several channels across social media: Brand Video Pro, the Kenim O Show, Stream OVG, and Stream OVG Business. But if you head on over to mintedculture.com, you can check out all my content in one place. Also, when you go on the website, you can book a one-on-one consultation or strategy call with me, and I can give you tips, tricks, and strategies in business, filmmaking, media, Web3, NFTs, all the above. So head on over to mintedculture.com to find out more. So here's the thing, right? Here's the thing with what she's saying, because I think she's spreading a little bit of misinformation here. So her claim is that, well, you've seen what she claims. The issue with what she's saying here is that sexuality is fluid, and this is something that is going to throw you off, right? And I learned about this because I was reading about asexuals and how they separate romantic interest and sexual interest. So romantic interest is completely separate from sexual interest. And here's the thing. Not too many people understand this. And when you look at asexuals, well, they have zero sexual interest, but at the end of the day, they still have romantic interests, right? So they might not want to have sex or perform any sort of sexual activities, but they still have interests romantically, right? They want to do romantic things. They want to be with, you know, actually, you watch videos on asexuals, they'll break it down for you, but they want to go on dates, get married, be together, have that companionship, all of that stuff. They enjoy that. So when it comes down to it, back to my point, sexuality and romantic interest is separate. Most people are probably skewing more heterosexual, and most people probably match their sexuality matches with their romantic interest. That's most people. But everybody is not the same. And that's just the truth. So when it comes down to it, when you look at the Kinsey 6 scale and you look at the scale and the fluidity of sexuality, right? The 0 being completely heterosexual, the 3 being completely bisexual, and the 6 being completely homosexual. And you see that spectrum, right? And you know, a 2 is like a little bit mild interest. I just put all the information here that you see it. So there's interests, right? And most people move one or two spots in their lives, you know, because sexuality is fluid. But sometimes people can, like I said, some people can take a complete left turn and go from 0 all the way to 6 just for one person. That's possible. But just as romantic interest, just as sexual interest is on a spectrum, so is romantic interest. And again, they're two separate things. So when it comes down to it, it is possible for you to be completely bisexual, right? But at the same time, you are heteroromantic, or you're somewhere on the spectrum skewing more to heterosexual. There's also the possibility that you're completely bisexual, but you're skewing more to homo or somewhere along that line. So that's where the spectrum is. So when she says most women that are bisexual want romantic, want to actually end up with a man, well, that's not most people, that's misinformation. That's people that are heteroromantic, bisexual, or skewing on that side of the spectrum are closer, gonna be closer to that. So for example, a heteroromantic bisexual, you could consider someone that is, their sexuality is a 3, and then their romantic interest is maybe a 1 or a 2. That's someone that's more towards, heteroromantic bisexuality. But for what she said in the video, I feel like she's probably maybe like, and you know, there's this whole scale, there's a whole quiz, you can do the quiz and figure out what you are. I'll leave a link to it down below. But I would say from what she said, I would just assume that she's more maybe like a 2, because she said she likes companionship with women. So she's more like a 2 when it comes to romantic interests. But when it comes down to sexuality, she's probably a 3. Who knows, right? And then there's some people, right, that could be a 6 romantically, so they're completely homo-romantic, but when it comes down to their sexuality, they're a 3. I've met someone that was a 4 when it comes to their sexuality, and a 2 when it comes to their romance. So that is a heteroromantic homosexual, which is like pretty much unheard of and probably a recipe for just not having fruitful relationships or anything. Not to come for that person individually, but I don't know how you work that out. But hey, to each his own. And at the end of the day, when it comes to attraction, when we think about the science of attraction, you can't control who you're attracted to. You can't control who you like. So it's not your fault. But the problem, I think, in society is that people haven't felt open enough to explore their sexuality. People haven't felt open enough to express themselves, especially men. So it's really interesting to see in this show, Euphoria, how this, you know, got super cisgender, heterosexual, well, not terrible, pansexual white man who grew up in the 80s, or sorry, who grew up in the 90s, turned into a pansexual man, probably, we're assuming, later in life, and is really exploring his pansexuality. And I assume that the woman that he impregnated when he was a teenager is now his wife, right? So he's still very much in a full-blown relationship with a woman, but chooses to have sexual relations with, you know, boys and men. And it's interesting that his sexual encounters, as we've seen, they're never really women. And is that because of the lack? Because he always had a scarcity of access to men when he was younger, and then, or in life, and now all of a sudden he wants to do that overkill because he only spends his time with his wife? Who knows? It's a very interesting dynamic to showcase on a show. And I think it's so important to have these types of conversations, so there's more understanding around sexuality and how fluid it is. And really just, at the end of the day, it is what it is. Be true to yourself, explore who you are, and, you know, the rest will come. Anyway, those are my thoughts. I really thought that was an interesting thing. I just want to have a little side note. I saw this interesting video about prisons. We know that this is a known factor, that a lot of men that go to prisons end up having homosexual relations, right? And on a sexual basis. And maybe I'll put a little clip in here, but why is it based on condition? If this is a heterosexual person, based on condition, the fact that you're in prison and you have zero access to women, some people are locked up for 10, 15 years, some people are locked up for life, you really can't really expect that these people are not going to have sex for the rest of their lives. So based on their condition, they have now decided it's okay to have sexual relations with men. And in this case, or even in the case of female prisons with women, homosexual relations, it just shows how fluid sexuality really is. And it goes all the way the fluidity can go all the way to being completely sexually active, all the way to being celibate, because there are people that are celibate at the same time. But when it comes down to it, when you look at these prison men in jail and women in jails, and then turn to homosexuality, but when they come out of jail, maybe they change, or maybe they've adapted to enjoy the taste. This is now something that they enjoy and they take on for the rest of their lives. At the end of the day, my point is, we have a saying in Nigeria, na condition we make crayfish bend, which means that it's the conditioning, it's your conditioning that will determine who you are, right? You are a product of your environment, and people will adapt to their environment. And so that is how adaptable sexuality really is, at the end of the day. Anyway, I'm not going to condone anyone sort of like bashing people that go to prison and choose to have those sexual activities. I think, look, at the end of the day, be yourself. If that's what you want to do, hey, do what you want to do. But this is just some perspective to let you understand. Look, not everything is as straightforward as you think it is. Sexuality is certainly not straightforward. It's fluid, it's dynamic, and people move up and down, jump from one end to the other in life. So anyway, those are my thoughts. Let me know your thoughts. Leave a comment down below. Don't forget to like, follow, subscribe, all the above. You're watching The Kenim O Show, and see you next time.